Yesterday, Raila Odinga toured Toy Market, where he made some remarks that are going to inform the basis of our analysis right now. But before we listen to Raila Odinga, let's quickly answer this simple question. Why did Raila Odinga tour Toy Market just a day or two after Nairobi Governor Johnson Sakaja was chased away and pelted with stones? What took Raila Odinga to Kibra? Raila was in Kibra to gauge the mood on the ground. He wanted to see how Kibra residents were going to receive him. And he did get that answer. Kibra residents were not hostile to him. In fact, they embraced him and listened to him, something that was very contrary to what a good majority of Kenyans, including me, were expecting. I think Raila wanted to gauge the mood on the ground. Is it true that he has lost his support by embracing William Ruto? The answer is very simple. His support is still intact. As much as his supporters are very mad and angry at him for embracing William Ruto, they still respect and listen to him. That's why he was not heckled. He was not pelted with stones. And I won't be wrong to say that as time goes by, most Raila Odinga supporters who are still angry with him will all be panel beaten into supporting Raila Odinga's position. That's the truth. That's the reality, ladies and gentlemen. Let's now listen to Raila Odinga, for his remarks are going to inform the basis of our analysis right now.
Sasa mmeona jamaa walikuwa mashindo na kazi. Wamevunja baraza ya mawaziri. Wakaja kwetu. Kwamba tuwapatie watu. Wakasema wanazipiga magoti chini. Tafadhali mpatie sisi watu. Watu wenu ni wajua. Mwaka jana tulisema tunataka sasa ifanywe nini? Ifanywe nini? Mambo yangekuwa tofauti sana kama ingefanyika. Unajua haya? Sio? Sio mashindwa. Tumewapatia sasa wataalamu. Mtaona kama kazi inabadilika. Mwaka jana tulikuwa kwa barabara. Tulikuwa tunalilia nini? Mambo tulikuwa ongejea mambo ya gharama ya maisha. Tulikuwa tunaongea mambo ya ukosefu ya kazi kwa vijana. Vile ni maneno ambayo hao vijana juzi Gen Z waliongea juu yake. Mambo yale yote bado yuko pale. Na tumesema mpaka yale yote yatatuliwe.
Na kuhusiana na tukio la moto katika soko la Toi, Odinga aliagiza serikali ya kaunti kuanza mara moja ujenzi wa soko hilo na kutaka hatua kuchukuliwa kwa wahusika.
Sasa leo nimetoa amri kwa gavana. Niambia kwamba hii uwa ambayo inazungusha hapa yote, ujenzi yake yaanze mara moja. Manake hapa wako na shilingi milioni 100 katika bajeti yao ya mwaka huu ya kuanza kujenga hii soko.
Let's now dissect those remarks by Raila Odinga. Raila is saying jamaa walikuwa wameshindwa na kazi, wamevunja baraza la mawaziri, wakaja kwetu kwamba tuwapatie watu. And then Raila Odinga goes on to say, tumewapatia wataalam, mtaona kama kazi inabadilika. Let's start with those remarks. I'm seeing Raila Odinga who is mocking Ruto. But now the question begs, how is Ruto taking those remarks by Raila Odinga that walikuwa wameshindwa na kazi? From where I sit, William Ruto has no issue or no problems with what Raila Odinga is saying in those political rallies. As long as Raila supports him in action, Ruto does not care what Raila Odinga is saying in these political rallies. Action speaks louder than words. Raila in deeds and in action supports Ruto's government. And we are even seeing members of parliament allied to Raila Odinga now supporting Ruto. Ruto understands very well that Raila Odinga has to manage the expectations of his supporters. So that's why Ruto might not take offense by Raila Odinga mocking him. Raila is just trying to manage his supporters. And should Raila succeed in managing his supporters, then that's a very big win for William Samoei Ruto. That's why Ruto takes no offense. And on the same note, Raila is saying, tumewapatia wataalam, mtaona kama kazi inabadilika. That's a very dangerous game Raila is trying to play. And I'm saying that because William Ruto remains the president. The buck stops with him. The previous cabinet that is sacked, we used to hear those cabinet secretaries anonymously saying William Ruto was making decisions at State House. And they were just being told to sign some gazette notices. So William Ruto was micromanaging the sacked cabinet secretaries. If William Ruto will not change that, then even these new cabinet secretaries will not deliver. And that will put Raila Odinga at loggerheads with his supporters because he'll be seen as another liar, just as William Ruto, promising things that are not there, giving empty promises. So that's a very dangerous game Raila Odinga is trying to play. Ruto, as long as he remains the president, he might as well sabotage these new cabinet secretaries. The blame will be on Raila Odinga because he has already assured his supporters that mtaona kama kazi inabadilika. So Raila Odinga has to be very careful on the type of promises he makes to his supporters. Some of those promises might end up backfiring simply because William Ruto still remains the president. Raila is not the president. He can't force William Ruto to rule the government the way Raila wants. This is Ruto's government. So Raila has to be very careful when making promises to his supporters. I'm also seeing Raila Odinga talking about the servers. That servers ingefunguliwa, mambo ingekuwa tofauti. Raila is still just continuing mocking Ruto. In a nutshell, he's saying William Ruto never won 2022 presidential election. But still, just as I've explained, William Ruto has no problem with those because Raila is just trying to manage his supporters. And that will be to the advantage of Ruto. And then finally, Raila Odinga is giving a directive to Nairobi Governor Johnson Sakaja. What does that show? It shows very clearly that the working relationship between Raila Odinga and Sakaja is that cordial relationship. Sakaja listens to Raila Odinga in spite of the fact that he's in Kenya Kwanza. He listens to Raila Odinga. And for those who can remember, a few days ago in this forum, I did explain one main reason why Rigathi Gachagua and his allies have been fighting Johnson Sakaja. Immediately Johnson Sakaja formed his government, his Nairobi County government, he brought several Raila's allies in his government. In fact, out of the 10 ministers in Nairobi County, 3 came from ODM. So you are seeing that 30% of Sakaja's government came from ODM. That's what angered Rigathi Gachagua, and that's why Rigathi Gachagua and his allies have been fighting Johnson Sakaja. Yes. So Raila toured Kibra to gauge the mood on the ground. As much as his supporters are not happy on him working with William Ruto, they are still ready to listen to him. That convinces me that as time goes by, Raila's supporters will all be panel beaten into supporting his position by working with William Ruto. A hoping majority, if not 80 or 90%, they will be convinced. Let me stop it there, ladies and gentlemen. If you are watching us but you have not yet subscribed, subscribe, give the video a like. Any person watching us outside Kenya, drop a comment, let us know from which part of the globe you are watching us from. If possible, subscribe, give the video a like. Let's meet in our next analysis.